Harvard Public Library. We're back at it again. And we're doing portraits. I found a sample portrait here, just doing a quick search. We're on unsplash.com. Found this cool portrait of this dude. Let's just see if we can continue practicing our photo retouching skills that I've been going through in the last couple of videos. So this should be fun. Hope you guys enjoy this. I'm gonna go ahead and open this image in Photoshop. So open up Photoshop. Oh, actually, let me find the image. Right click, show in Finder. Right click, open with Photoshop, and I'm gonna use 2020 for now. I have 2021 downloaded as well. I just got to do the switch over, but 2020 is gonna work fine. And this image is great. We have a lot of detail, a lot of things to work with. You could tell that the focus was really on the eyes. The forehead looks slightly out of focus. It's really in focus right here. The nose is a little in focus till you get here. The lips are nice, super in focus. So this is pretty cool. Let's go ahead. Yeah, let's make this copy. All right, and we're gonna do frequency separation. So we've learned that you gotta make two layers. On the first layer, you're gonna apply a blur. So we're gonna go to blur, Gaussian blur, and you just want to apply enough blur so that the skin texture is not there. And the reason for that is because we're really trying to focus on skin tone, and that's what the low frequency is going to allow us to adjust. The high frequency is where we're going to do texture. So yeah, I say something around a 6 seems okay. Maybe even, let's see, that's too blurry. 13 is too blurry. 8. What about a 7? Yeah, sure. This is it before. This is whip blur before, whip blur, so. Alright. I'm going to say that's fine. That maybe 6.5. Maybe 6.5. Maybe 7. All right, 2.7. Okay. So that's the first layer, low frequency. Now we're going to go to the top layer, and we're going to go to image, apply image. We're going to source, that's the source image, and I think we hit the top layer. I think it's the top layer, and you go down to subtract. No, it's not the top layer, it's the middle layer. There we go. All right, so if you do the top layer, you don't get anything obviously because it's subtracting itself, but you want to subtract it from the layer below. The numbers are going to be scaled to the offset is going to be 128. I'm going to stop talking after I do this, and we'll just get into it. I won't talk as much, but hit OK. Now we want to blend the layers together. We're going to go to linear light. And if we did that correctly, you should see the image looks exactly the same. And if I turn off the high frequency layer, I get the low frequency layer. Turn on. So essentially these two are merged together, and the way we know it's merged together for real is that we bring our base image to the top, we turn it on and off, there should be no difference, right? So when it's on, this is the image that we're seeing, right? If we turn it off, there's no image. If we turn these on, right, and we turn this one off, same image. So our image is frequency separated. All right, so pretty easy. We'll start with blemishes first. So I'll turn off the texture layer because I don't want to work with textures right now. I just want to smooth the skin. And because I'm still a noob at this, I don't know where I really should be targeting. I mean, I see some rosiness here in the cheeks. I see maybe something in the brow we could smooth out. I mean, my personal opinion is that this is a great portrait. In my own photography, I wouldn't really touch this up because I like naturalness. I like to capture moments and things how they are. But we're learning photo retouching. So we're going to simply override that, and we're just going to jump straight to how can we make this a more ideal image. And definitely would be smoothing out this skin, removing some of these blemishes. So yeah, I want to turn off texture again so I don't confuse myself. I'm going to go to the healing brush. I want to make sure source is on sampled. I'm going to make sure it's on current layer. And the mode, I'm going to make sure it's on normal for now. And I'm going to just make sure my brush is all the way set to soft. Soft brush. And yeah, maybe that size is fine. Maybe a little smaller. All right, let's see. So if I want to fix this red, So that's what starts to happen. Obviously, if you go too much, you start putting the lips in there. Let me see if I need to adjust anything aligned. I might just need to make the brush smaller. Sample this. Fix out the rosiness. So I'm going to do this really quickly, and then I'm going to go back and take a look at it. So if we go to our history, before, after, before, after. So, but if we go out, I mean, you could clearly see that it's, you clearly see the brush marks, which is what I'm still struggling with. Like, how do I erase my brush marks? But definitely that blotchy area right there, it's moved out, right? It's like a dab of Neutrogena. We're going to try one more time, except I'm going to open up a new window. So arrange, new window, and then I'm going to go to arrange, and I'm going to go to up vertical. And on this image, I'm going to basically zoom in like here. And on this image, I'm going to zoom in way more. And I just want to be able to see how those changes are playing out. I guess it wasn't that bad. I guess it's not that bad. What I thought I did is if you look at these this area here, right here and right here, it doesn't change. Well, right about here. Yeah, it doesn't change that much. It's changing. I mean, this whole area is the area that's really targeted. But you see this spot up here? I thought that was me. And it's not. It's kind of his natural skin tone, especially this area right here. So maybe this wasn't such a bad brush. Maybe we just need to continue. Certainly, I suck at this, so if I make mistakes, which I certainly will, you guys will be able to see. All right, so we're using the healing brush, and I'm going to go, where's my layer? Okay, I'm on that one. Cool. So I'm going to sample over here. And as we see the change gets made, let's just keep going a little bit. Okay, let's take a look. Oh. So this is before. This is after. This is before. After. Before. After. Yeah, so I really cleaned it up. That is insane. So let's back out of this image. before. That's after. That's before. That's after. So, pretty cool. You know, pretty cool. I can't lie. Let's do some more. I see this part of his face right here. It looks pretty dark. Let's go ahead and give that. Let me make sure that, yeah, I'm on the right layer. Let's go ahead and touch that up. Okay. So I'm gonna go before, after, before, after. That's pretty cool. So what we saw, let's go to before. We have darkness here in his cheeks and that dark spot right there at the end. Right, we can see it over here. We hit after and they're lightened. All right, so it just rounds out the rosiness of his cheeks ever so slightly. Let's see. This, there's a spot right here. I can't tell if this is a birthmark or what. It looks like maybe it could be a small scab or a birthmark. Not sure. We could try taking that out. So, spot healing. I'm going to sample from an area right around it. Once. Twice. Let's just take a look. So, before. After. Yeah, it's pretty. So before, it's there. You can see. After. Pretty nonchalant. I guess if we want to do it, we could do it one more time. Hit it up. I'm not sure it's doing anything though. Let's see. Before. After. Yeah. Let's see if I sample one more around it. Yeah. Let's go before. After. Yeah. So, for all intents and purposes, it's there when you zoom in. It's not when you zoom out. That's cool. All right, let's work on the eyes. So we look at the eyes, what we're seeing. Again, I don't really see anything wrong with this image. I'm a street photographer. I like seeing things how they are. But one thing that I am noticing is, let me get my zoom. Like if I was trying to beauty retouch this, I'd see the eyes are really dark. Here, I don't know if they're too dark. I don't mind it. It looks maybe a tad bit just too dark. So we can try and correct this. Eyes can be very difficult. So let's go ahead and give this a go. All right, so if I was going to be on this image, I'd probably sample starting from here and go up. So I'd sample from here, maybe. Okay. And I have my align box checked on because my source will move with my brush, so it makes it just like a tad bit easier. So what I'm doing is sourcing on the left side, and I'm actually looking on the right side what happens, because it's a little easier to see it from a distance. So, don't want that. I'm just trying to watch out for any areas where the darkness comes back, because I don't want the darkness. And I'm going to strokes of one, you know. So let's take a look at where we're at. So this is before. This is after. And it gets a little easier to see, like, what was going on when you do the before and the after. So, this is before. This is actually the image before. This is how his eyes were. This is after. And actually, his eye just looks a little bit smoother. What happens is, as we get near the eye, this is a really dark spot. I can tell you right now, I'm nervous on how to fix that because I feel like I'm making it worse. Let's try. Oh, okay. That wasn't so bad. One more. 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 Yep. That might be it. What I'm seeing now is his nose. It is. See, this is the problem with retouching. It's like you just start going everywhere now. But like, I feel like if you were good at makeup, you can be good at retouching. I just feel like because you understand, like, skin tones more. I don't know. See, what I feel like I'm doing now is I'm pushing the dark spot up his eye, and I don't want to do that. Oh. All right, that might be it. There's this dark spot above his eyebrow. Maybe that's it for now. All right, let's take a look at that. So we're going to hit before. Wow, we actually did a lot. I mean, look at this. Wow. Alright. So this is before. You ready? And this is after. That's insane. So already you could kind of see. Maybe on this side is a little easier. You could kind of see the changes. And like I said, this is all, I guess, preferential to some degree. I mean, there are ways to make this uglier, I guess. But I certainly don't mind the portrait. Once again, I like the way the light hits this person's face. In certain areas, it gives it a sharper look. It also looks a little bit stark. So, I don't know. Personally, for me, I kind of enjoy that. And he's a male figure, so it certainly goes well with the image. If we go to the after, we just touched up some of those areas. And not bad. I mean, it's not like it takes away from the image in a way. But yeah. So, I might leave that alone for now. I mean, we certainly could work on the other eye, but they're a lot more even now. You know, they're a lot more even. So if we work in the other eye, we could throw it off, especially since I feel like more light is hitting this side of the face. So what I want to go through and do now is really quickly just work on some of the texture. So we want to be able to take out this line under his eye here and see if we could smooth out his forehead a little bit. His dimples are fine. That's a character. That's part of his face. Yeah. I don't know if we could smooth out some of that. probably get rid of this and probably get rid of that line up there. All right, so let's get started. We're gonna go to layers and we're gonna work now on our top layer. This is the high frequency. I'm gonna go ahead and rename these for you guys because maybe I'm being confusing. High frequency. I'm gonna make this low frequency. All right, so we're gonna work on the high frequency layer. And for this part of the editing, we're gonna switch our tool. Actually, we're gonna work with a clone stamp tool. And yeah, same idea. You sample texture and you apply it. So say I want to sample this part. I make sure my flow is pretty low. 10% is fine to start off with. Again, brush settings, soft. And pretty small. Let's go. And I feel almost sometimes like that. I feel like the texture editing part can be a little bit more difficult because depending on where you sample, you're painting with another part of the texture. So I feel like you can easily make this a mess, which I've done plenty of times already. Because I've taken an area where I'm trying to fix the texture and I just painted another texture there and it doesn't look the best. So what I found myself doing with textures is just like this, like having to sample a lot. I always move where my source is because I feel like I don't want it to look like the same part of the face all over the face. So in an effort to keep it natural, I try sourcing different areas. So this line is proving very difficult to get out, but it will. Now what we can do is, since I see it, it's gone, it's pretty much gone, we can go back on our low frequency and adjust the tones, because we still have, now that the texture is not there, we still have that feel of that line. So let's take a look. Before. Oh. After. Before. After. And we can only go back so much, but if we did, we'd be able to see more of the line. But just so you can see, it's going back about maybe 40, 50 steps, maybe 30. And what we're noticing is this part of the line that I was working underneath the eye. So you can see how right here is really dark and now it's not. So let's go back and let's go to the low frequency and let's just see if we could, and we're going to switch our tool to the healing brush and we're going to make sure, yep, current layer, and we're going to sample and then try to just okay. So let's go to this side. Let's just take a look. So look how many healing brushes I did. You know, just in the last like 2 seconds. So that's why you, and you can only go back so much. So, but as we could tell, you know, if we go back to the clone stamp tool, the line isn't there so much, but what's there is the mark of it. And so when we did the healing brush, we're removing the mark. And so it has a much more natural vibe. Now, there's still much more work. Like, I see this line here that we could probably get rid of. And I'll probably work on that right now. But you certainly don't want to overdo it. So let's work on that real quick. Sample this. Get rid of this. Yep. And pretty much there. I wouldn't go crazy. That's kind of aggressive. Let's go back. So, yeah. All right. Nice. Let's move on to this line up here. Clone stamp. We're going to make sure that we're on high frequency. Go back. And let's like source over here. And pretty much there it is. It's gone. And maybe this line over here we could take out a little bit. All right, so now that that's smoothed, and certainly maybe a little bit of this. Now that's smooth, now we can go on to layers, low frequency, back, spot healing brush, sample this, and then just do away with the mark. Over here, same thing. A little too much, let's go back here. And sometimes you just need to dab it. And we'll probably have to work on this side of the eyebrow too, but let's just take a look. So that's what we were dealing with. And it's not there anymore. So let's go back even more. And gone. So it's gonna one more. Healing brush. Gone. Now we could work on this side of the eye because I feel like I'm starting to see how this can go. So make sure we're on the low frequency. Spot healing. And let's just see if we can. What I'm creating is like small marks in his skin. Certainly I feel like, see, that's too much. If I had like a bigger brush, maybe I could do it in like one swoop, but I guess that's the part of this that I have to get better at. So, before, after. Before, after. Alright. So, those dark, like, edges around his eyes, we definitely, like, smoothed out. And I just want to say, too, like, this was a pretty well-edited image. So, the colors are working great. You know, there's different instances if like the image wasn't edited as well, like certainly these reds along the edge of his hairline could be more prominent, and then you might have to go back and do a lot of healing work with that. That's certainly more difficult. I couldn't do that. So So yeah, those are things to consider. I'm wondering if we should hit the eyes. I don't know if I should hit the eyes a little bit on this side, because maybe that side looks a little bit too toned up. I think it's a little obvious. So I'm going to go ahead and low frequency spot healing, sample this and just see if I can, just ever so slightly. There. Maybe. I could be doing like way too much here. Let me just see on the side of the face. All right, so let's take a look at. Oh wow, so yeah, that was the eye before. And that, so before, wow, white. It's crazy how like you don't notice it at first, but then like after you do the retouching, it's like, oh, it's obvious. Like that was a little too dark. So right underneath his eye, we have this really dark edge there. After it's pretty smoothed out. So what I found though is like, I mean, what I see is though is like it kind of feels like we're flattening out his face. That's the one thing I don't like about it. So we go back for that stark edge, you know, it's cool, but this side of the face is smooth. So and then there, but yeah, so I think that's fine. The eyes now really match. His line is gone. Oh, we got to do the forehead and that little blemish on the side, and we might be good to go. So let's go to high frequency clone stamp. I want to zoom in just a little bit. All right, so say I want to mess with this. Just kind of going through. With the clone stamp, you're going to notice it just looks blurred. Like if you're taking texture in the right areas. And that's because you're just trying to get away that dark edge of the line. And then with the spot healing brush on the low frequency, that's where you could go in there and really do the final erasing of the line, because what you're doing at that point is you're then matching up the tone of the skin. we're doing is softening. Just softening all these hard looking edges on his face and some of these blemishes. Just soften up this part of his forehead because I see a lot of porridge. Did I just say that? Porridge? I meant to say pores. All right. Alright, that might be it for now. Let's go ahead and jump to the low frequency spot healing brush and let's just smooth out the tones. And I know that I'm like starting to develop a little eye for this, so I can start to see the small changes, certainly in the skin tone. Alright, I don't want to smooth this face out too much. It almost looks like... Damn, I might have done it a little too much. It almost looks like there's a white halo now on his forehead. Let's take a look at... This is where we were at before. Oh. No, we're good. I guess that's how the lighting was. When you take out all the texture and the smoothing, it kind of looks just flat. I guess that's one of the issues of it. But yeah, so that's it before. You know, you have these textures, these little lines, different things like that, and then you go through and heal it. And it's pretty smooth. Alright, let's work on this guy down here. We're going to go to textures, high frequency, clone, and we're going to just try to clone out that texture as much as we can, smooth it. So now it's a spot. Now it's a dark spot. We go to spot healing or just healing and nope. We just moved it up. We want to just there you are. So before, after, before, after, one more time, before, after. Alright. His chin looks a little dark. I guess we could smooth that out. I don't want to get too crazy with this. Let's go ahead and inspect anything else. No, that seems kind of natural. I don't know. I don't even know what's natural anymore. That's the problem with editing, I feel. You know, don't even know what's natural anymore. Alright. Well, we're going to see what's natural in just a second. This is where we are with the edits. When I turn this on, this should give me the image before the edits. Let's take a look. Wow. Wow. All right, so that's before. I really can't believe. That's insane. That's before. This is after. So before. after. And definitely when you do that, you can start to see areas where you could hit it up some more, especially like right here on his nose. This little area right here could probably get smoothed out. Right there. But like, wow. So before, after, before. So definitely, you see his brows. It looks like he's scrunching his brows a little bit more. Certainly his face has more, I think, slight more character. When you take it away, you really get eyes. We could probably even sharpen up his eyes a bit more. And I wonder, like, I don't even want, I mean, we could try to clean up the eyes. I don't even know how good I would be at that. We could certainly try to lighten the eyes. So that would be cool. Let's try that. So that's before, after. So I think the skin's in a cool place. I don't think you have to go anything more than that. All right, so how do we... Let's do something. Let's group... let's copy these. Group those together. And turn this off. And we'll merge this group. So now we have a complete image. Now what we can do is work on top of this image, and let's see if we can work on the eyes. I don't know how to do eyes, actually. I was literally just learning skin tone. Let's see if we can do so. I think we'll dodge it. I know I'm going to totally botch this, but I don't know. Let's go exposure 10. Oh, I see. Okay. So like that. Let's go over here and just go through the eyes twice. And there we are. Zoom out. All right, let's take a look at that. So, eyes before, eyes after, eyes before, eyes after. That's pretty cool. So before, after the, before, after. Maybe it was too much. I don't know. Before. Part of me feels like it could get lighter, but then. I don't know. I want to, like, do something to the eyes. Certainly, if I had this adjustment layer on a. Like, if I had this on a different layer. Maybe that's what I should do. Maybe I should work on. So I'm going to go new layer. Leave everything normal. I wonder if it'll still work. Can I dodge? No, see, it's not going to work. Because there's nothing to dodge. All right. Yeah. All right, let's go do it once again. But let's work with, like, an exposure maybe of, like, 8. Let's go... 2, let's go 3, 4, alright, and we're over here, 1, in the middle, 2, in the middle, 3, 4, okay, let's back out of that, let's check that out, go before, after, before, after. Just gives it like a cool little glint. Wait, let's do it one more. See how it works. think this side needs like just that. Yeah, let's go. Before, eyes look pretty dark. After, there we go. Alright, so to see these changes like really, really like prominently, we're gonna go back and forth between the old image and the new. So before, after, before, after, before, after. So the eyes are coming out a little bit more now. Alright, let's see what else we can do to this. Sponge, I forget what is it doing. Changes the color saturation of areas in the image. So we're set to saturate. Let's bring the flow down to like 10%. I just need to see what it does. Bring our brush up, and once again, just want to make sure it's soft. So okay, we could already begin to see some changes. Let's go one more time. All right, let's go over here. One, let's go one more time. All right, let's back out. Maybe that right eye needs to get a little bit more color. That's before, and that's after. Let's just sponge it up one more time. All right. So it's cool. It's almost starting to get like a little glint in the eye. Now I think this side just needs a tiny bit more. It's gonna go 1, 2, 3. And you can start to see the hairs a little bit more saturated. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, guys. I don't know. This eye on the left side, it's pretty messed up for me because it's got those hairs going through the eyeballs, and that's kind of throwing me off. But before, after, let's back out. Before, after. It does change the eye color slightly. It makes it a little bit more warm. I don't know if I like that. I don't know if this dude would like that. His eyes look green, and now they look really green. I guess hazel. I guess they look like they have more sun in them. I don't know. But his eyes are definitely there now. I feel like they weren't shining before. Let's take a look. That's before. This is after. Before. Before. After. Before. Awesome. His eyes are pretty sharp. If they weren't, I would sharpen them up a little bit. But they're pretty good. And yeah, maybe what we could do now is a slight global adjustment. Let's add an adjustment layer. Let's go down to curves. This is where it'll get like really, really difficult for me, because like I see some magenta, some pinks, but like I said, I think this image was edited pretty like well, so I could mess this up. Let me see. At the top, let's bring up, make it brighter, and then at the bottom. What we risk doing is the same thing that we try to correct for, which is give this guy some more shadows on his face. And certainly as we do that, he becomes more red, which is what I don't want. Maybe he just needs more mid-tone contrast. Let's just do the before and after. So it's before, after, before, after. So it's like gives it a little bit more like HDR. Now all I'm seeing is a little bit too much red, so I'm gonna go to the blue. And well, let's go to the red for now, and let's check this out. And I think the opposite of red would be, what's going on, brother? Would be like RGB, CM, like cyan. So there. So yeah. So drop this down on his face just slightly, and it becomes a little bit more bluer. Maybe we want to give some of his skin back. So there we are. Just bring it up slightly. Still too much red, blue, kind of like right there. So we're gonna go before, after. So certainly before, with this off, now you get the picture. Look how red the whole image looks. And now after we did like a slight color adjustment, that's where we are. So this is the before, this is the after. So this is the before, and this is the after. This might be it, you know? This could be it for this image. There might be more that we could do. Certainly the pros. One thing that we could do if we had more time and if I was pretty good at it was the hair cleaning. So if you look all around his hair, you got these strays. Certainly you could blend that in with the background, clone stamp that out maybe. I won't get into that right now. Certainly because I think that's one way you could do it. I'm not sure. So I don't want to mess with it too much. I think we're cool, guys. I think, you know, this is it for this image. This is before. Took out some of the blemishes, brightened up the eyes, gave it saturation, and then we just did a global curve adjustment to balance out the reds in this entire image. And this is where we ended up. So before, after. Yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I think I'm going to keep doing more of these. These are pretty like relaxing, enjoyable. And yeah, I'm out. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.